Hello everyone. Today's topic for group discussion is artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is the ability of a computer program to learn and think. Anything can be considered as artificial intelligence if it involves a program doing something that we would normally rely on our intelligence.
I'm here to talk about the advantages of artificial intelligence. One of the biggest advantages is that it reduces human error. Human error is one of humans make mistakes like usually, and it happens all the time. So computers, however, do not make all these mistakes. With artificial intelligence, the decisions are taken with the previously gathered information, and it uses a set of algorithms. So errors are reduced and chances of reaching accuracy is high.
Yes, Amma, I agree with you. But isn't this AI making the human so lazy with its applications? Like, most of its applications are automated. Majority of its work is being automated. So like, if humans get addicted to this type of inventions, this might cause a lot of problem to the future generations. Like, they might become so lazy.
It's not making people lazy. Instead, people will be still working on their creativity part. Like, for the decisions where they have to think and make something, people will be working on that. Whereas for the jobs which are repetitive, like sending mails and making documents, and in the documents where the errors should be reduced, for those particular things, the robots or the AI machines will be working. This will reduce people from working on their boring parts and instead use their mind and energy on the creative parts.
Yeah, I accept, but I think for the repetitive jobs and the boring jobs you are talking about, I don't think there is any reason to have robots which are made of higher cost, and also it requires maintenance of these robots. So for these repetitive jobs, I don't think you need to put this much price, and you need to get a robot to do these silly jobs.
Yes, I agree, but it's a one-time investment. So this is considered because artificial intelligence is available for humans, customers, or anyone, like for more than 24 hours, like for 24/7.
Yeah, sounds like it is available 24/7, but isn't this availability making a cause of unemployment? Like, if this AI is replacing the majority of these repetitive tasks, so this might cause a lot of unemployment. Like, every organization is looking to replace the minimum qualified individuals with the AI robot means. This will cause a lot of unemployment in the future.
This is not going to cause the unemployment, because the first point is the people are only ones who are making the robots. So if the unemployment will be caused in this sector, it will be created in some other sectors. The employment will be created in some other sector. And along with that, for the jobs where the risk is involved, where the human life is at risk, we can make machine to do those tasks. Like in any fire extinguishing work, or in any natural disaster or human disaster, in those cases, instead, if a human will do the work, there is a risk of their lives. Whereas if a machine works, there are chances of more accuracy, more efficiency, and the risk is less.
Yes, Aishi, but what I think is these robots are pre-programmed. So during these natural disasters that you are talking about, if the robot doesn't really know the solution to like if they cannot really act on spot, like if the new problem arises during this natural disasters, then I don't think there is any robot that can solve that can think on its own and solve a problem accordingly.
See, it also helps us with digital assistance. Educational institutions, helpline centers, hospitals, etc. uses digital assistance. So organizations have a customer support team. So they work all the time, and at any time, humans take their help, and it's useful.
Yeah, somehow it is available in digital assistance, but this you need to understand one thing is that machines can't alter their responses to changing environments. So like, that is the basic premise on which these AIs are built. So this repetitive nature of work where the input doesn't change. So machines can't judge what is right, what is wrong, or they're not capable of what is legal or illegal, that kind of things.
For the new task, we still have humans to work for those kind of things. But for the tasks which are predefined, like where we can tell the machine that this is right and this is wrong, for those particular tasks, the decision making by the robots will be faster and will be more efficient. Like, the error will be less in those decisions and they will be faster. So this will reduce human efforts. Along with that, it will increase the efficiency of the particular task.
But I think, you know, even in the tasks, like the old tasks which you are talking about, there needs to be improvements, right? Like the world is changing and it has to be updating day by, like every day. So I don't think the robots will be able to update themselves. And again, the human's involvement has to be there to update the robots. So it's I think it's time taking, and also it's very much cost effective. It's not cost effective.
Thank you, guys. Those were some nice points. As we have seen, these are some advantages and disadvantages of artificial intelligence. As we know, every new invention or breakthrough will have both advantages and disadvantages. It is upon us how we use it. So when we use the artificial intelligence to its limit, we all could really enjoy the outcomes of it. Thank you.